What's up, guys? I'm Emerald Marie, and be sure to check us out on the web at realfansrealtalk.com.
This is your African King's comedy, Michael Blackson. You're watching Real Fans Real Talk. Get real with it, my son.
Only things that we can actually talk about, especially as far as basketball goes, is the Last Dance. You were a little bit more involved, especially like understanding how the contract situations work. I just want to touch on Scottie Pippen's contract situation and why it's important to have people around you to, you know, when you're making those decisions.
When I was watching that, I was like, there's no way his agent should have allowed him to sign that contract. There's no way. But at the end of the day, you know, he, from my knowledge, from what I saw, you know, guys told him not to sign that contract.
Yeah.
He didn't heed that. It's not, there's only so much you could do. If everybody in your corner is saying, don't do it, you can't force, you know, the hand of Scottie Pippen. He made that decision himself. You know, Mike told him not to do it. The president or the owner of the Bulls told him not to do it. When you have an owner tell you not to sign a contract, why would you sign it?
Right.
But I understand both sides because, you know, like he said, like Scottie Pippen said, he wanted to take care of his family. You know, he wanted that security. And trust me, when you come from nothing and you have the opportunity to make some bread to, you know, to support your family. You know, your family comes first. That's all you're thinking about.
Yeah.
Family. I could do this for my family.
I'll give you $18 million for 7 years. It's going to be like, oh, that's the best thing in the world. But, you know, as far as NBA goes, when you're a top five player and you're the 122nd ranked paid player, it's a little bit, you know, different.
But when he signed that contract, he wasn't the top five player. He became that. You got to remember, Scottie Pippen started playing basketball late in his life. It's not like he was, you know, a good player all his life, and people were like, "Yo, you guaranteed that big contract. Oh, you good. You this. You that." So he wasn't he didn't have that. He was just like, he might have been in position where he was like, "Yo, I made it to the NBA. Oh snap! Let me get this bread real quick because I don't know how long my career is gonna be." He didn't have the Michael Jordan, the LeBron James mentality where they were like, "Yo, I'm gonna be the best player in the NBA. I'm gonna be the best player in the world." Like, he didn't have that mentality. He didn't have that mentality. He might have just been happy to make the league.
Now you're 1,000% correct, and I'm so glad that you mentioned that. Because that's one of the debates we've had on the show and we've touched on, where people look at Scottie Pippen and they only look at the finished product of what he became. They don't realize, as you mentioned, when he signed that contract, he's coming off his rookie deal. He was not viewed in that same way at that time. They were just coming off their first championship. He was viewed as a good player. Yeah. But in 91, he had only one All-Star appearance up to that point. He wasn't the finished product. He was still very young in the process. And one of the things, as you mentioned, about just wanting to take the contract, from the research I was able to do after I saw that, because I kind of felt the same way, that it was a little confusing he was signing that. But one of the things I learned was that he actually was rushing the process to sign his second deal. And in that process of rushing the second deal, he kind of just got caught up in the fact of, I'm getting $18 million as opposed to what's my actual worth. And that's also pre-Dream Team. Dream Team came the following season. So had he waited it out a little bit, obviously his value is much stronger to get a better deal.
But again, no one knew Scottie Pippen was going to be the Scottie Pippen he turned out to be. Not even Scottie Pippen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, again, and that comes from, you know, again, I touched on it, him blossoming late in his basketball journey. I don't know exactly when he started playing basketball, but it was late, wasn't it?
He wasn't even on a basketball team his freshman year of college. He got that scholarship during his sophomore year.
Exactly. So had he been like, you know, these other guys like myself playing basketball their whole life, where they, you know, they're competing against guys their own age, and he's like, oh yeah, I'm better than him. You get to the next level, and oh yeah, oh I'm the best at this level. Then you get to college and you realize that you're the best at each level that you go in. Then you start to develop a mentality like, yo, I can make the NBA and possibly make a lot of money from it. But
right.
The fact that he started out late, he didn't even play basketball on his as a freshman in college. He was just like, wow, yo, I'm in the NBA. Okay, let me get this bread real quick.
Yeah, absolutely. He said himself, I mean, he didn't even get the reason he got a scholarship. He was the team manager on the college team. And he was only able to get a scholarship because there were other guys who either were flunking out of school or just weren't doing the right thing. And it kind of opened up the possibility for him to be on a team. And I think one of his good friends, I don't know if they were teammates, but one of his good friends had even said he kind of had a growth spurt in college. And he went from being 6'1 to 6'5 to 6'7 by his junior year. And as you mentioned, he blossomed late.
Smush Parker here, formerly of the Los Angeles Lakers. And you are now tuned in to Real Fans Real Talk.
This is Real Fans Real Talk. Real fans, real talk. We as real as you thought.